the guys. It's Kevin here. It's been a while since I've done one of these videos on the 70s Revisited. And I don't know what I got here, 12, 13 albums out of my collection that I'm going to show. Some of them you may have heard of, some of them you may not have heard of. Just leave a comment below. I'm going to go through these real briefly. I'm not going to go into long details, possibly. Anyway, first up, so I think it's the second album half from this band, and it's currently what's playing. This was released in 1970 on Atlantic Records, talking about Juicy Lucy, and Get a Whiff of This. Nice. Bought this about a month ago at the Fargo Record Fair. And decent price. I think I got it for $10. It's got a little snip right here, but like I say, from 71 on Atco or Atlantic Records. Of course, this song here, done by Spirit. Just a great hard rock band from the early 70s. I think they did three, maybe four albums of that. But this is a good start to the 70s Revisited. And yeah, it's kind of I love the cover, man. It's just absolutely fantastic. But this has, what is it? 9 tracks, which was kind of the norm back in the early days. So anyway, first up, Juicy Lucy. Number 2, also found at the Fargo Record Fair. I showed this in an update probably 3-4 weeks ago. I've been trying to fill out my discography with this band and artist, and talking about Taste or Rory Gallagher, whatever you want to call. This is Taste, early Taste. This is from 1970 on Polydor Records. And this is a live album recorded live at Montreux Casino in Switzerland. It has 6 songs on it. But one of the great guitarists of the world that is really, really missed. I love the Rory Gallagher's fucking playing is just fucking phenomenal. I think the early Taste is indicative of what to become on the solo stuff. But anyway, here is some Taste, some live Taste. Up next, I showed this in an update a couple weeks ago. I had just got a chance to really hear this in detail. And this band put out one album and one album only. I believe these guys are out of the Northeast, New Hampshire, Maine, in that area. Anyway, I'm talking about Dogs. Kind of a mishmash of some soft rock, hard rock, a little bit of maybe a southern in it, maybe a little blues, just kind of a mix of everything, but a great album. This is actually an original copy that was still in its shrink. Anyway, if you have never heard them, check them out, Dogs. This is going into the 60s, so this is the only one I have that's into the 60s. This guy is probably, I don't know, one of the mainstays of the mid-60s, early 60s to come out with the British blues. And has still continued to do the blues today. And this has got a great lineup on it. I'm talking about John Mayall and the Blues and Breakers and their album Hard Road, which came out in 1967. And it has on here Ansley Dunbar. Of course, Ansley Dunbar is the drummer. He went on to do Ansley Dunbar's Retaliation. I think he went into Earthquake as well, I think. But guys, a great drummer. And of course, John McVie, of course, went on later to form Fleetwood Mac with Mick Fleetwood. Peter Green, of course, another great guitarist. And of course, John Mayall, vocals and keyboards. But some great stuff here. This is on the Decca Records label. And if you like British blues, which I do, definitely check out John Mayall and the Blues and Breakers. Okay. I remember this band when I was stationed in Duluth, Minnesota in the late 70s. I picked this up at a record shop downtown. I think it was called The Last Place on Earth. It was a head shop. And they had, you'd walk into the store and off to your right when you got in were import vinyls, and then around the other side were new and used albums, and then right in the center was all the head shop stuff, punks, pipes, rolling papers, rolling contraptions, hookahs, you name it, they had it there. And I found a lot of good stuff there. And I came across this group there. And I loved what I heard. I picked this up as a buying blind because of the cover. And the band is called Marseille. I didn't think they'd be French, but they are not. This was released in 1979 on RCA Records. And I'm trying to think of the track that maybe you have heard, which I think it was called Rock You Tonight. Of course, this has Nick, Neil Buchanan, Andy Charter, Stevie Dinwiddie, Keith Knowles, and then some intervention on this album was done by some of the Ian Gillan Band and UFO members. I believe this is the only album that was put out by Marseille. And I finally found another copy of this. And it was a decent copy. But late 70s hard rock, great stuff from Marseille. And a band that I came across a couple years ago, and I heard one track off of it. This came out in 1974. And just some great stuff from Dog Soldier, self-titled album. I'm trying to think of the song on here that is absolutely a great track. It's a very long track, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, Looks Like Rain, which tracks almost 12 minutes, about 11 and a half minutes. Phenomenal track. Very, very good hard rock from the mid-70s. Definitely check them out. Some Dog Soldier. Up next, I got two albums from this group. One's a promo, one isn't. I never see anybody ever show this stuff. I came across this band back in the late 70s when I was stationed in Duluth on a college station out of Superior, Wisconsin. And I'm trying to think of the song. It was the song Kicks. And I loved what I heard. I went out and purchased all their stuff. And very rarely ever see anybody ever show this band's material. I have everything they've ever put out. And anyone talking about the band Earthquake and their album Leveled, which, let's see here, what year did this come out? It came out in 1977 on the Berserkly Records. This is a promo here. And let's see here, I'm trying to think. Robbie Dunbar, it's not Ansley. I think Robbie Dunbar is Ansley's brother. So Ansley did not go in to play with Earthquake. But this band is just a fun hard rock band out of the 70s. Five albums they put out. Like I say, this is the demo. And this is not the demo. But Berserkly, it's kind of a label that had a few good bands on it. Greg Kinn was on that label. And I'm trying to think of the other band, but I just can't think of it. But anyway, here is some Earthquake and Level.
Well, the world's still there, but the outside's gone.
Early on, this band out of Canada, pretty famous. Huge following up there as well as in the States. And but this is one album that I don't know, it never really got any exposure in my opinion. I think it's the best album they ever put out. It's different, but it is a great album. And I'm talking about BTO and Street Action. Of course, this has C.F. Turner, Bachman. Rob Bachman, Blair Thornton, and Jim Clench. And to me, this is not like their earlier BTO stuff. That is more hard rock. This has a lot of blues vibe to it. And one of my favorite songs on here is Madison Avenue. Just a great bluesy hard rock track. And a very underrated album in my opinion. I never see anybody ever show this BTO, but definitely pick it up if you like BTO, and I thoroughly think you'll really like this. This was actually released in 1978 on Phonogram Records. Up next, a band that did two albums. I saw them once, I believe it was in 1975 or 1976. It was on the Blue Oyster Cult tour. They were touring in support of their album On Your Feet or On Your Knees, and this band opened for them. They did two albums and then they were gone. And I'm talking about the band called Baby. This was released in 75, so yeah, it was about 75 I saw this group. It was Baby, Oyster Cult, and ZZ Top on that tour. It was Dakota Jam 2 or 3. Supposed to be outside, but bad weather kind of forced it into a pavilion, which was absolutely miserable. No AC. It was like 120 degrees in there, just muggy, sweaty, and hot. But I'll tell you what, great show. ZZ Top didn't finish the lineup or their show because they got dehydrated. They did like four tracks and they had to leave, but Baby was fantastic. They're kind of more hard rock, maybe a little southern influence in their sound. I'm looking for a decent copy of their second album. I haven't been able to find a decent copy. But anyway, here's a band called Baby on the Mercury record label. It was also on cassette and 8-track. Like I say, 1975. Another long line of great albums from this band. Many lineup changes. And probably my second or third favorite from this this discography. Talking about Savoy Brown and Looking In. Great album. Man, you gotta love the cover. Absolutely phenomenal cover. I mean, early in them 70s, bands like Budgie, Savoy Brown, Armageddon, just to name a few, had some absolutely phenomenal covers. And this is another one of those. Of course, this came out in... God, what... It's on the Parrot record label. Of course, this has the later lineup with Kim Simmons, Lonesome Dave, Roger Earl, Tone Stevens. Of course, Lonesome Dave and Roger Earl went on to form Foghat. But if I would have to choose a favorite Savoy Brown, it would be Street Corner Talkin'. I'm not exactly sure, man. I'm sorry about that guy. I know it was probably about 71, maybe 72, this album came out. And, looking for a better copy. Got a little bad spot here, but just some great bluesy rock from this band. Can't go wrong with anything with Savoy Brown related, but anyway, Looking In from Savoy Brown. Up next, Canadian band. I got a few Canadian bands on this. And anyway, no exception. I've been looking high and low for this. I finally found a copy on Discogs for a decent price. And this one has always eluded me for years. And before I get into this, this album is just about over, and I'm going to put on another album here for you guys. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this series of the 70s Revisited. I've just been in a recording mood all day. I'm going to put up a bunch of videos. I believe, two more to do, and then I'm going to be done for a while. I haven't done the 70s Revisited in quite a while. I think the last time I did one was probably late spring, early summer, if then. But I've just been kind of delaying doing these. You know, how sometimes you're in the mood, sometimes you're not in the mood. And I have been in the mood today. And I think I got three albums left. But anyway, give me a sec here. I'll get another album going for you guys. Okay, I'm back here. Here's what's playing right now. Taste. I'm going to turn this up a little bit so you can get it. Hear this a little bit, and then I'll get back to the albums. Where the world you get that sugar from? Tell me, sugar woman. His vocals and his guitar style are indistinguishable from anybody else. Great stuff. Woman. Alright guys, I got 3 albums left here, and anyway, getting back to this one, it's been a while, or it took me quite a while to get this, finally got it, their first album. But they do 8 albums. A band that should have and could have been bigger, but they were not. They had quite a few radio hits, but they just didn't get the notoriety like their counterparts Rush did. And I'm talking about Triumph, their self-titled album from 1976 on the Attic record label. Of course, we all know the classic lineup and the only lineup. Rick Emmett, Mike Levine, and Gil Moore. And Street Fighter is an absolutely great track. 24 Hours a Day, to me a very underrated album. I think the next 3 or 4 after this got more notoriety than this one. But this is a gem of a self-titled release, and everybody should own this. Great stuff from Triumph. Another great band out of the 70s. To me, they're heaviest. They're kind of diverse in each album. Their diversity changed, I should say. And this one to me, I remember when I first heard this, was floored. And this was produced by Randy Bachman. I think he discovered this group. This album was on MCA Records, came out in 1975. And just a heavy piece of hard rock here. They went on, I think, what'd they do? 4 albums? 5 albums? Between this one and Flying Colors, my 2 favorites, I'm talking about Trooper and the self-titled album. And my intro to Trooper was General Hand Grenade. Roller Rink, great track. General Hand Grenade, great track. In Trouble Again, just some killer guitar riffs on this. Great vocals from Ray McGuire. Again, a band that should have been bigger, but weren't. I don't know what it was with those bands coming out of Canada in the early days, other than Rush, that really never got the notoriety like a lot of bands in the U.S. did. Maybe it was the border difference, I do not know, but these bands should be bigger than what they were. A great, great release from Trooper. Last one. I've had this since, mid-70s. I bought this again at the record store in Duluth, last place on earth. There were like 3 or 4 record shops right in a row downtown. I lived just up the hill a little bit, so I had no car. So I always walked to these shops. I was in the Coast Guard at the time. And I came across this album because of the cover. Again, just a classic cover from a classic band. I believe these guys put out 4 or 5 albums. To me, this is their best. They are out of the UK, and I'm talking about Tucky Buzzard and All Right on the Night. And kind of a mix of hard rock, a little bluesy hard rock, but Rainbow Rider, classic song. Rudy, movie star, classic song. Fast Bluesy Woman, great track. Again, 4 to 5 albums these guys put out. They're all great albums, but to me, this is the pinnacle point of, Tucky Buzzard, like I say, 1973, excuse me. They were on the Purple Records, but they were on the Passport label. And just some great stuff from this group. Hard to come by nowadays. You rarely see any of this stuff at used shops. I think I came across one other copy, a different copy, not this particular album, but another Country Buzzard album. But other than that, I don't know, it seems to me in certain used record shops, you have very little of early rarities of the 70s and 60s, and then you in the middle you have thousands of commercial classic rock bands, Boston's, you know what I mean, stuff like that, and then possibly you'll find some gem imports, but you'll never find a lot of this stuff there. But anyway, great band, Country Buzzard. So anyway, that is another installment of the 70s Revisited. Hope you enjoyed this latest update, and leave comments below and let me know what you think. And anyway, thanks for watching the 70s Revisited. I'll see you next time, and keep it 70s.